In this video, we're going to talk about oil separators, what they are, how they work, but most particularly, which one is best for you. Mark, what we're trying to do is do the impossible. We're trying to help everyone figure out which oil separator is best for them, and we don't know what's going on.
Yes.
So let's start with, what are the different kinds of oil separators?
Okay, so there's two in our range. One is a coalescing plate separator, the other is a hydrocyclone. The main factor to determine the difference between the two, or what is required for the application, would be the flow rate. So how much water do they need to process per hour? So typically for a wash bay, for a car for instance, we see flow rates between 1,000 to 3,000 litres an hour. And for the larger applications, such as in the mining sector, we see flow rates from 10,000 litres an hour to beyond 50,000 litres an hour. So the hydrocyclone can manage from 3,000 litres an hour to beyond, and the coalescing plate separators are between 1,000 to 5,000 litres an hour.
Okay, so that makes sense in terms of how you determine which one's which, is simply figure out how much water you need per hour. Let's just go backwards for a sec. Can you give me a quick summary of how an oil separator works? But also, we haven't really spoken about how the hydrocyclone works. Can you give me a quick...
Okay, so a coalescing plate separator uses media packs to help the free oil molecules coalesce, come together and float to the surface of the water. That is as simple as it can be.
So that's the principle, that oil and water separate if you give them a bit of time, let the oil rise and skim it from the top.
Correct.
Okay.
A hydrocyclone, we use physics, centrifugal forces to separate the oil and water molecules. And without going into too deep on how it works, a vortex will easily spin out two weights, if you like. So water being the heavier component and the oil being the lighter. The heavier components are pushed out to the outer sections of the vortex, mm-hmm. and the lighter in the centre.
Okay.
And then they go in opposite directions. So,
oh, that's good.
That's a very simple way of putting it.
That's handy.
But
one goes up, one goes down. One's on the outside, one's on the inside.
Correct.
And okay.
We have a very simple way of separating oil and water.
Okay, and you've spoken about going from 3,000 litres per hour up towards 10 and 20 and 50,000. How big are we talking about? What do these devices look like?
They can be as small as a coffee table, and they can get quite large, the size of a car. Typically, a coffee table would be between a 1 to 5,000 litre an hour unit, and a coffee table would start to get into the 10, 20 and up to 50,000 litres an hour.
Right, so sorry, the car ones become up to the 20 size.
Yes, sorry, car size. Yep,
no worries at all. So if you are trying to figure out which oil separator is best for you, what you're talking about is the litres per hour. Can you give me some examples? You said wash bays are 1 to 3,000, mining is 10 and 50,000, just a couple more industries and a sense of what their flow rates might be, which would help people figure out which one is right for them.
Okay, so if you look at a car wash that has, say, a 5 bay, then we're looking at potential flow rates of 3 to 5,000 litres an hour. In a single, say if we use a portable car wash for instance, mm-hmm. we typically look at between 1,500 to 2,000 litres an hour.
Mm-hmm. All right, so then what about applications, I want to say wheelchair is now going to be, which you've spoken about using a wash bay for, is going to be much less than that.
Mm-hmm.
So you move towards the coalescing answer.
Correct. Yeah, so a lot of the time the coalescing plate separator will be the answer, because 80% of the time, even 90% of the time, we're talking to clients that have flow rates less than 5,000 litres an hour.
Okay.
And if we do go beyond 5,000 litres an hour, you can still put a pigeon pair coalescing plate separator in. So two fives will make up 10,000 litres an hour.
Right, you can add them together.
Correct.
Okay, good. Look, I think that's actually pretty clear. It's very easy to figure out from that and which industry you're in, which oil separator would be best for you. Anything else that you'd like to add to that conversation?
I think we covered it.
All right, terrific. Thank you so much. For those of you who'd like to find out more, please visit us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au. Please send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to chat through your specific circumstances and help you figure out which of these techniques is best for you.